What up everyone, welcome back to the channel, Jamal here. And in today's video, we're going to learn how to clone a React Native project from within GitHub. So let's get into it. All right, so the first two main tools that you're definitely gonna need to have is Android Studio as well as Xcode. So if I go into my launchpad, if I do Xcode, I already have this installed. You can install this via the App Store as well as Android Studio. So two very important tools that we're going to be using and demoing today. And we also going to need some build tools. So you're going to need to have React Native installed on your machine, as well as Node and Yarn. So if you don't have that installed, or you want to check to see if you do already, we can go into the terminal and we can do npm version. That's going to tell us our npm version. We can do yarn version. What's up with my S's and D's today? And we can also do the React. I also have some notes if you want to take a look at some of the notes. So we just did the React. I can just copy this just to show you that I am running. Make sure to remove bullet points, because sometimes it gets a little tricky. So it's easy just to copy, paste. React Native version. Okay, oh, there it is. So it did work, I didn't see it the first time, but here it is. So we are running on 2.0.1. So these are our build tools, so we just have these already installed. We do need to install them. You can just simply run these commands. So I'll paste these in the description if you guys need to have them so you can install your tools. So let's hop into cloning our very first React Native sample project or template, whatever you want to call it. So I'm just going to go into Google, do a quick search for React Native free templates. You're going to find this website. 21 plus best React Native templates of 2022, including 5 free. So we're gonna scroll down to the free section. Here we are. So the template we're gonna be looking at today is number 4, the React Native Starter, which is pretty nice and simple, just a basic app just to show you how you can clone a React Native project in GitHub. So you just wanna click React Native Starter. You do have different versions. We're just going to do the free open source, and you can get it via GitHub, and it's going to bring us to this page. All right, so now we're on the GitHub page. So you just want to scroll down, read some of the documentation and see what you're really getting. And this is what we're going to try to build on both Android and iOS. And that's the beauty about React Native. It's cross-platform, Google App Store. So it doesn't really matter. So let's get started. So the first thing you want to do is clone the Git repo. I have a mobile projects folder, so I'm going to build that React Native right here. And let's open up our terminal, and we're going to cd into that location. So I'm just going to do cd. I like to have my folder next to me, and I'm just going to drag that right into here and then click enter. All right, so now we are cd into that mobile projects. So what I'm going to do is git clone the React Native project right here. So let me make this a little smaller, get my terminal up and loaded, clear some of these windows. Okay, so you're going to copy the very first line, and we're going to paste it. So now you see clone and info, and it already cloned that project really, really fast, which is good. And the next thing you want to do is navigate to the clone folder and install the dependencies. So we can do cd react this and install. But before we do that, I do want to make some updates into a few files. And this is going to make sure that our app is built correctly with no glitches or no issues. So let's fix those. So if I go back to my notes, I have upgrade Gradle and React version. So upgrade Gradle to 6.6.1 and upgrade React to 0.63.2. So let's do that. So let's hop into our folder. So this is the React Native starter folder that was cloned into that location. And what we want to do is go into Android, and we're going to go into Gradle. We're just going to go into the Gradle wrap properties and open with, let's do Visual Studio Code. So what you see here, Gradle, we're on version 5.5. So let's update that to 6.6.1. Command S to save that because I'm on a Mac. And then I'm going to close that file. And the next one we want to do is update the package JSON. So we're going to update React inside the package JSON. We can open Xcode, okay. And we want to update it to React 0.63.2. So once our package JSON open up, we're going to scroll so we see React. So we are currently on 0.63.1. So just do that to 2 and click Save. All right, just those two small quick tweaks. And now we're going to go back into our terminal and let's continue. So navigate to the clone folder and install dependencies. So this cd React Native starter and yarn install is going to do that. So let's come here, paste, and then enter. So right now it's just going to build, so I'm just going to let that build for a little bit. Alright, that's good. So the next thing we want to do now is install pod. So what we're going to do is cd into the iOS and do a pod install. So copy this line, copy, and this is going to cd into iOS and do a pod install. Alright, so now that is complete. What we want to do now is, before we open up our React project, what we want to do is start our Metro bundler. So create a new window. And what we're going to do, I'm going to cd back into my cloned folder. So right here. Just going to click and drag to make the process so much quicker. So once I'm back here, what I'm going to do is, now I'm going to do a yarn start. So this is going to start the Metro bundler server. So do yarn start. Nice. So now we have our React Metro bundler server running. Pretty good. All right. So now what we're going to do now is, I'm going to build the Android version of the project. And if everything goes well, I'm going to build the iOS as well and show you how both of them just look. So the first thing I want to do is open up my Visual Studio Code. Go to the top, go to File, Open Folder, and we're going to open our React Native Starter folder, and it's going to look like this, which is good. So what we want to do is, in Visual Studio, let me minimize this. So what we're going to do is go to Terminal, New Terminal, and once we are here, we're going to do a yarn run Android. So let's copy this, copy, and we're just going to paste this here, yarn run Android. So before you run this, please make sure that you have an emulator already set up on your Android Studio. If you haven't, I already have a video on how you can configure your Android Studios and build an emulator. So please be sure to check that out if you haven't. So what we're going to do is now is click Enter. Now it's going to build the package, and this may take some time. So I'll be back once it's done. Alright, now we can see our build ran successfully. So what we're going to do is give it some time to load. So there it is. loaded successfully. So this is the React Native starter. And this is, let's see what it comes with. So there's a calendar. You can open this up. Let's see what happens. Have a nice little calendar page. We can close this X right here so it don't be too distracting. We have grids. Okay, nice. So you can click on each of these items available in full version. So we go back. Scroll works. I love how you have that lazy load. As you scroll down, it loads the image. We have a list view. So we click on that. Yep, available in full version. As well as list view components. So in the components, we have different radio buttons, 1, 2, 3, action buttons, icons, a drop down, option 1, option 2. Pretty good. So you build your Android React Native. And this is done just by cloning via GitHub. Didn't take much. Very, very easy to follow. Next, what I'm going to do is create the iOS build. So now that we have the Android, let's head back to the home. Let's try to create one for the iOS now. So now that we have our Metro bundler open, we're going to use Xcode to build our project. So navigate to the Finder and let's go back to our React Native starter folder. And we are going to go into the iOS section. And we are going to open the React Native starter workspace. So double click, let that open up. Okay. All right, now that it's opened up, you can see it's processing. We can change the device that we want to use. So let's say I want to use an 11 Pro on version 14.4. So that's a simulator that I want to try to push this application onto. But let's let it do its thing and go through the processing files. All right. It said it's ready to build. So let's click the play button and see what happens. All right, it say we are building, it's constructing. Okay, so far so good. So let's give this a little minute or two to load. Alright, now that we have our iPhone 11 Pro booting up, it looks like the build looks successful. So let's just give it a minute or two and see what happens. So we see the Metro is doing its thing. It's gonna load, boom, and it's up. So now we have the iOS device loaded with the application that we just built on the Android, and it's functioning well here as on the iOS. So if you take a look, both display the same. There's so much real estate on the iPhone 11. You can tell how much space is below. We have settings. So we click settings. It just takes us to the map, the calendar, excuse me. We have components, so it takes us to the components. Components. And pages, let's see, pages. Everything works, looks good. We have our footer icon, so we can click these as well. And it moves nicely. But that, there you have it, guys. That's how you create or clone your very first React Native project using GitHub and actually build on both devices as well. If you guys like this video or you found this video helpful, please be sure to smash that like button, subscribe to the channel. I'm going to be doing more videos on Appium and mobile testing, so definitely going to be a lot more content, so much stuff to learn. So stay tuned, and I'll see you guys in another video. Thank you for watching.